Hello everyone, in this session, we will learn how to deploy Laravel on shared hosting. I already have a starter Laravel project with simple authentication using Laravel Breeze for this tutorial. The source code is saved in a GitHub repository. Here, I am using one of the hosting providers in my country. I will purchase the single web hosting package because it is the cheapest. This package falls under the shared hosting category. You can purchase a package from any hosting provider you prefer, but make sure it supports PHP, MySQL, and SSH. I will buy the package for only 1 month. Then, choose the payment method you can use. After making the payment, they give us an option. I will choose Create Website. Then click Next. For this option, I will choose New PHP HTML Website because we are using Laravel. Next, we are asked to enter the domain. You can enter the domain you want and then proceed with the payment. For this tutorial, I will use a temporary domain. Then, we can choose the server location closest to the user base to minimize latency. Let's wait until the setup process is complete. Okay, this is the view of our hosting dashboard. We also have our temporary domain. Next, we open the file manager of the hosting. Then open the public HTML folder. This folder will be where we upload our Laravel project files. Let's delete the default.php file. Then, we go back to the dashboard and open the SSH section. Here, we can see that SSH is not active on our hosting. Let's activate it. Next, we change the SSH password for later use. We copy the SSH command and paste it into the terminal to log in to SSH. For the first input, just type yes. For the second input, enter the SSH password you created. Once successfully logged into SSH, move the working directory to public HTML. Then you can clone your Laravel project repository. I am using a public GitHub repository. If you are using a private repository, you will need to set up a token for access to clone the repository. Let's try to check the public HTML folder with the file manager to verify the contents of the project. Next, we need to build our frontend assets on the local machine. The result of the frontend asset build will be uploaded to the public folder in the project on the hosting via the file manager. We do this because the shared hosting package we purchased does not support Node.js, so we can't build the frontend assets directly on the hosting server. However, if your package supports Node.js, you can build the assets directly on the server via SSH. After uploading, we need to copy all the contents of the public folder from the project to the public HTML folder. Okay, the frontend assets are successfully uploaded. Next, we need to upload the Laravel project dependencies in the vendor folder by running composer install optimized for production on the local machine. We do this because the shared hosting package we bought does not support Composer v2, so we cannot install dependencies directly on the hosting server. However, if your package supports Composer v2, you can install the dependencies directly there via SSH. After installing the dependencies with Composer on the local machine, we need to upload the vendor folder, which contains the dependencies, to the Laravel project folder on the hosting server. Just wait until the vendor folder upload process is complete. Okay, the vendor folder upload is finished. The next step is to edit the index.php file in the public HTML folder using the hosting's file manager. Here, we need to change the .dot folder to the name of our Laravel project folder. After editing, don't forget to save the file. Next, we need to run PHP artisan storage link, but on this shared hosting package, we cannot do that because the exec function is disabled. As a result, when we try, it will result in an error. To resolve this, we can manually create a symbolic link for the public storage folder via SSH. The symbolic link is successfully created. Now we need to upload the Laravel projects.env file. We open the .env file to configure the environment variables. I set app debug to false, then app URL to the temporary domain. For app env, I leave it as local because, for some reason, when I change it to production, there are some issues with the Laravel project. Next, we need to configure the database. First, we need to create the database through the hosting dashboard. Then we create the database name, username, and password. For the password, I use double quotes to ensure that special characters in the password are readable by the Laravel.env. Okay, the database is successfully created. You can continue configuring the .env file if needed. Once done, save the .env file. After that, go to SSH. Then move the working directory to the Laravel project. Migrate the database. Then optimize Laravel to cache everything so Laravel is ready for production. Okay, the deployment is successful. Let's check the Laravel website by opening the domain. Let's explore the website, and yes, it seems to be working fine. Don't forget to turn off SSH on the hosting if it's no longer needed. Let's try to see the structure of the Laravel database with phpMyAdmin. There are many limitations with this shared hosting package, but these can be worked around. Moreover, the price of this package is very affordable, making it suitable for someone learning how to deploy to hosting. Okay, that's the tutorial for deploying a Laravel website on shared hosting. See you next time.